This is Somajit Das. Welcome to Take Your Time. So in this particular video, we are going to discuss the schedulers in RxJava. Now, before jumping into the video, I would really like to say that this is the fourth video of the playlist that I am creating for beginners to learn RxJava in Android development. So in this one, as discussed, we'll completely focus on the scheduler part of RxJava and how to use threads and concurrency, achieve concurrency in a perfect manner using RxJava. So in our last video, we have actually formed the first observable chain and we wrote the code using RxJava for the first time. And in that one, if you can notice, in this particular block which I have highlighted over here, these are the two lines where we have used threads. So if you can see that subscribe on schedulers.io and observe on Android schedulers main thread, these are the two lines where I have declared that declared little bit about threads. Subscribe on schedulers.io means we asked the asked our RxJava to do all the operations in schedulers.io thread pool, and then after completing the operation, give me back the data in Android schedulers main thread. That is what we have said to RxJava by declaring observe on, that I want to observe the data on Android schedulers main thread. So this is what it is in terms of forming the chain, but we have not discussed in a very good manner that which kind of threads and which kind of thread pools you have to use and what is the perfect scenario where you can use which one. And the best part of that one, what we are going to learn right now, is which thread we should not use at which point, and what are the benefits of what are the pros and cons of all the threads. That is what we are going to dive into and learn in this particular video. Now, before jumping, I would really want to say again, in this particular tutorial series, I am going to cover all the basic needs for a developer to learn RxJava in Android development. So if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please subscribe to this channel to get more contents. Now, the first thing first, we'll see that schedulers in RX world, so there are four different kinds of schedulers available for us. And the first one out of those is IO, which we have already used in our last video. And afterwards, you can see that there is one thing called computation. The third one is trampoline. And the fourth one is Android schedulers main thread. So these are the basic ones that we know we have in RX world. Now, if you can notice that Android schedulers main thread is the only one which I have, I have a little bit green in terms of color, and that is what I want to highlight over here. Because this is a particular thread that is not given by RxJava, that comes from the library of Rx Android. Basically, what is the need of that one is, so this is used to bring back the execution to main thread. So what happens in this is, basically, if you can think that whatever the why mostly we use RxJava in our Android development is, either we are going to bind our views with that one, or we are going to do some asynchronous calls or some heavy calls which we don't want to do in our main threads. So we are going to use do that operation in a separate thread. But at the end of it, we always, as an Android developer, we know that we cannot update the UI without being in the main thread. So keeping that in mind, Rx Android library given us this particular thread, where using that we can always get the data, observe on that particular main thread, which is Android schedulers main thread, and update our UI. So that is the main job of this particular thread. And there is one more thing, that is usually we use it in observe on method, because always we want to update the UI in main thread. So for that one, we observe the data changes in that thread. Now, apart from this four, there are other different threads also available. There is one single, there is one new thread, there is another one immediate, there is another, and the best part of that one, you can actually use executor schedulers to create your own custom IO schedulers. Now, one thing we haven't yet discussed is why we are calling schedulers, why we are not calling threads. So basically, schedulers in terms in Rx world is none other than an abstraction provided to us by Rx, where they have created certain factory methods which has the proper guidelines and proper execution of thread pools. So basically, when I am talking about schedulers IO, I am just asking Rx that give me a thread pool which where the rules and sets are defined by you, which will be used by me. So they will be just providing an abstraction layer. We'll just call IO and they will be giving us a thread. The similar thing happens for computation and trampoline, and all these things are having different sets of rules. So and we in this particular video we'll dive into those rules and how things are happening and what are the things happening in behind when we are calling IO, computation or trampoline. That is what we are going to learn. Now before going into that one, for this single new thread immediate, these three I want to discuss a little bit about those things. For single schedulers.single, it always works on a single thread. So even if there are multiple observables working, if they are asking for scheduler single, there will be only one thread there, everything will happen. And for new thread, every time you ask for a new thread, schedulers.newThread, every time Rx will spawn a new thread for you. But that is a little bit problematic, because if you have so many observables working on so many new threads and the work you are asking Rx to do on schedulers new thread for everyone, then this unbounded situation may occur. So that is one thing you have to take care of. And that we'll discuss more further on the IO part of that one. And for schedulers immediate, when you are asking something to Rx that I want this particular job to happen in schedulers immediate, so no, then what Rx will do, no matter which thread currently you are working on, Rx will take that same thread and start working that particular job immediately. So your job that Rx was doing previously, that observable chain will come to an halt, and this one will have the precedence over that one. And afterwards, once this is completed, then the last one will start rolling. Now these three, please go further and learn about all these three more in Rx articles, Rx Java articles. You can have so many articles in internet. Please go through this one, because I have just covered those topics, those three topics in a little manner. Now let's just put all our focus in IO. So what happens in the last video, when we wrote our first observable chain, we told Rx that okay, I want to subscribe on schedulers IO, I want this job to happen in schedulers IO. But what we are meaning by that one, and how Rx is doing that? So basically IO is none other than, it is backed by a thread pool, and it is generally used for IO related stuff. That does mean network request or file system operations. Also, when I am talking about these things, I am actually talking about some sort of tasks which may take some time to happen. So basically you are calling for a network request, you don't know when the network request is going to come. So in those operations, IO is the best thing for you. Now when we are telling Rx that okay, I want to operate this on schedulers IO, but how it works in behind the scene? So what happens is, when you, for the first time, let's say there is one observable chain already there, and there you are asking that subscribe on schedulers IO, then what Rx will do, Rx will first see that whether there is any thread available in IO that is actually you are using already with that one or not. If it checks that okay, there is no thread with which you are currently working which comes from IO, then it will spawn the first thread for you, first IO thread for you it will spawn. Now let's say the observable is working and the job of that observable is not yet completed, so disposing of that particular subscription has not yet happened, and again there is another observable where you are again asking from Rx to work that particular job also in schedulers IO. So even if this particular job has not finished, IO will spawn another new thread for you. So basically it happens like the first thread came, but still if the first thread is operating, first scheduler's IO thread is operating some sort of job, and then again you are asking for another one, then the second will come, then the third will come, then the fourth will come, and eventually there will be lot and lot of threads that will keep on coming from scheduler's IO thread pool if all these are doing their job. And so that is a problem in this case. because there might be a situation it can go unbounded, and so many schedulers IO threads are acting at simultaneously, and there might be a drastic effect that can come on the performance side of the application. So there is this thing you have to always keep in mind. So you should not always ask for schedulers IO. You should always think that, okay, this kind of job is job actually completed, then I should ask for another one. Because if you don't do that, if you have multiple jobs running and everywhere you are asking schedulers IO to give you threads, then it will keep on spawning new threads. So that thing you have to really take care. And there is one more thing you should have a note of, that one IO actually, so if this kind of job gets if it continues, then there might be this, what I have said, this unbounded nature will come up. So for that one, what rule IO thread pool has already achieved is, every time there is an inactivity of a particular thread which is given by IO for 60 seconds, it will remove that unused thread. So that is, with that kind of rules and regulations set in place, they regularize the IO thread pool. Now there are two different other things also. Basically, one of them is computation, which we have already seen in the last few slides. So basically, computation is something that is also backed by a thread pool, this particular scheduler. But there is one catch here is, for IO, the limit, the number of maximum number of threads spawned by IO scheduler was not something you can count. It might go long as you want actually as a developer. But in case of computation, the number of threads in the thread pool is equal to the number of cores present in the system. So if you have if your application is running on a device which is dual core, then your thread pool will have only two threads into that one. So this is how it is. But in terms of computation, there is one problem, there is one big problem, that is waiting. So what happens in that one is, I have already told the number of threads present is equal to the number of cores present. So if you are running on a dual core, so only two threads you will be having. So let's just assume that you are asking for schedulers computation, and there are two observables already running which are running on schedulers of computation, and you want another one to run on schedulers computation. Then the third one will never start working until and unless they're out of these two, one completes its work. So there is this waiting thing that comes up. But when we use computation, it's mostly not related to the IO task, because for IO, asynchronous operations, we rely on IO. But in terms of computation, the CPU extensive works, like some algorithmic tasks, some math related tasks, or complex logic related tasks, we try to move that to computation. So basically, one set of logic related tasks in our Android development, if we are running one, we generally not run another one. So schedulers is something you should not have any problem to deal with that one. Now apart from that one, there is another thing called trampoline. So this is a very it's a kind of different one out of this computation and IO. So basically, in terms of trampoline, is the basic funda is, it will run the job on the same thread currently which you are working on. So if you are saying that, okay, Rx, work this one in scheduler's trampoline, then what Rx will do, the current thread that you are working in, it will start the job in that thread. But the same thing I have discussed in scheduler's immediate also, but there is a difference between immediate and trampoline. In case of immediate, what happens is, the work will start then and then. If there was any previous work that was happening, that will get halt. But the new work will get the precedence in case of scheduler's immediate, and that will run in the current thread only. But in case of trampoline, it will wait for the current task to complete in the current thread, then it will start its own task. So here it is, it waits for the current task to execute completely. So these are the basic things you have to learn in terms of schedulers that is given by Rx. And if, and again, I am just going a little bit back. So because Android schedulers is something we have already discussed previously, so I want to again recap that one, that Android schedulers is something that we as an Android developer mostly use because we have to update the UI at the end of the job, and to update UI we always need for main threads or UI threads. So that is what the use of Android schedulers. And apart from all these, IO, computation and trampoline are the main things that you should be using, and mostly as an Android developer you will be using IO. So these things always keep in mind what to use at which point of time and which one not to use. So that's it for this particular video. In our next video we might discuss some different topics. Maybe I will focus on the operator part of that one, and afterwards maybe I will focus on, you know, flat map, map, switch maps and even merge operator. And mostly I will try to explain all these things with different examples, real life examples. Maybe in case of flat map I will take an example of making synchronous API calls with Retrofit and RxJava and use flat map. Maybe in case of zip I will try to use, you know, my parallel API calls to explain that zip operators and all. So all these things are will keep on coming. So make sure you subscribe to the channel. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye.